Oh, hi there. It's Matthew here from Midland Pictures. How are you? What's that? Oh, you want to talk about external hard drives? We can absolutely talk about external hard drives. Why don't you join me on a journey into the wonderful world of external hard drives? All right. I can only keep that up for so long. Today, we're talking about the best types of hard drives to use for video editing. Let's do it.
Save it for conversation.
Now, this is a bit of a tricky topic to get a single definitive answer to because there are so many different types of video editors. Some are mobile on a laptop, some are in a multi-editor environment at a post house. Not only that, there are editors with varying levels of skill when it comes to organization. Some editors are completely disorganized with their data, their projects, media, putting their projects in their archive and freeing up space, cleaning out the render files on their FCPX libraries. And some are hyper-organized. They only have what they absolutely need on their drive. Their FCPX libraries are free of unnecessary render files. They're constantly aware of how much space they have available on their drives. So how do we say which drive is best for video editing? Well, you don't. You say which drive is best for each type of video editor. So I've got this fancy little chart here to break it all down. Starting in the upper left, you've got your mobile editor. So coffee shops, in and out of an office setting, maybe you're a teacher making content and you're at school and at home, you're mobile. And you're a little disorganized. You're not good at keeping your files and media nice and tidy. Folders, forget it. Just dump your media wherever it's easiest and figure you can worry about it later. Now below that, we've got mobile and organized. Top right, you've got immobile, which I spent at least 15 minutes trying to come up with a better word, but kind of gave up. So immobile, let's just go with it. You sit or stand at a desk all day and never really have time to move your edit rig. So you work on something like an iMac or a Mac Pro. Some of you immobile editors are disorganized. And then looking at the lower right, you've got immobile editors who are organized. Those to me are the four basic types of video editors I see most commonly. So each type of editor I think has a unique solution for which hard drive is best for them. So let's start with the mobile disorganized video editor. Because you're disorganized, it's probably best to work with a higher capacity drive so you don't have to stress too much about offloading your data when the drive gets full. If you've got a 1 terabyte drive and you're disorganized, your render files and media are going to use that space up quickly and force you to either organize your data and then offload it, or it's going to force you to do something scary like start deleting stuff. Usually what ends up happening is you post in your Final Cut forum on Facebook saying, "Hey, Final Cut keeps telling me my hard drive is full," and then all the nerds like me tell you to delete your render files, archive older projects, or buy a larger hard drive. And this cycle repeats endlessly because, let's face it, you're probably never going to get organized. So you probably shouldn't edit off of your internal hard drive. That's too risky. Can't work off of a RAID or a plug-in external hard drive with a lot of storage. That's not practical since you're mobile. So your best bet is a large capacity bus powered drive. And I'm going to go ahead and recommend an SSD because if you're disorganized, you may not be terribly careful with an external hard drive that has a spinning disk inside. You're going to eject that sucker and immediately toss it in your bag. And the disk will still be spinning and it'll cause damage, and over time that hard drive is going to fail. And then you're screwed. So what about speed? If you're editing 4K and above, you're going to need a USB-C 3.1 or higher hard drive or Thunderbolt 3. You need a fast drive so you have the read-write speeds for that footage. If you're editing 1080 footage from your phone, you can get by with a USB-A 3.0 or higher drive. The footage just isn't demanding enough to warrant the more expensive options of USB-C 3.1 or higher. So for me, your two best options are as follows: a 2 terabyte Samsung T5 or a 2 terabyte SanDisk Extreme Portable. Now, if you're somewhat tech savvy and you want a more custom option, consider getting something like a used LaCie Rugged drive with USB-C 3.0 and then purchasing a 4 terabyte SSD like a Samsung 870 QVO and taking apart the LaCie Rugged, which is very easy to do, and swapping the spinning disk drive it comes with for the 4 terabyte SSD. All in, this is probably going to run you around $600 to $700, but I think it's the option with the most bang for the buck. If you're editing 1080p iPhone footage or DSLR mirrorless like I do, all of my vlogs are filmed in 1080p media on my EOS R, you can store a ton of media on a 4 terabyte SSD, and the drive, even with USB 3.0 speeds of 5 gigabits per second, is plenty fast enough to play back your 1080 footage. If you want things to be a touch faster, snag that used LaCie Rugged but with a Thunderbolt connection and swap in a 4 terabyte drive to that. You may need an Apple dongle that adapts Thunderbolt 2 to Thunderbolt 3, but you may see a little boost to your read-write speeds over Thunderbolt. Now, the 4 terabyte options give you time to be disorganized. It's going to take that much longer for your drive to fill up with render files or media, and you can get away with being messy for longer. But when that drive fills up and you're stuck, it's going to take you that much longer to get all that data organized or offloaded. So for all of you mobile editors who are organized, you may be thinking that these options for the disorganized editor suit you well. I certainly think the used LaCie with a new 4 terabyte SSD route is a strong option, especially if you're using a Thunderbolt drive. But because you're organized, you have the ability to save a little money and buy a lower capacity drive. Maybe just a 1 terabyte Samsung T7 for $169 versus a 2 terabyte T7 for $279. I think the best options for the mobile organized editors are Samsung's T7 at 1 terabyte or SanDisk Extreme Portable at 1 terabyte. If you're editing in 4K from prosumer or pro cameras, then look at getting 2 terabyte versions of those drives with higher read-write speeds, 1,050 megabytes per second versus 550 megabytes per second. The Samsung X5 portable SSD with Thunderbolt 3 at 2 terabytes is your best option for both speed up to 2,800 megabytes per second and portability. LaCie also has an SSD Pro hard drive with Thunderbolt 3 that, for me, really hits the sweet spot of all the things you'd want as an organized mobile editor. So the LaCie would be my choice. But let's say you're like me and you almost never edit remotely. You're not lugging a laptop to the coffee shop to edit a vlog. You've got a desktop workstation with a sit-stand desk, and you like to have all the stuff that comes with a desktop workstation, a nice comfy chair, some in-out devices like card readers or USB hubs or extra monitors, but you're disorganized. It doesn't make sense to work off of portable external drives. And large capacity plug-in externals are slow and cause problems when you, on occasion, work with 4K footage. You need something that's large capacity so you don't have to worry about your organization as much, but still has some real speed. So you might go to the LaCie website and check out their one big dock options. These are really nice drives because they're Thunderbolt 3. They have a CF and SD card dock built in as well as a USB 3.0 Type A port. You can get capacities between 4 and 16 terabytes of enterprise level storage. It's a great all-in-one option, especially if your disorganization extends to never knowing where your SD and CF card reader is, or if you're on an iMac and it's a pain to get behind the screen to plug into a USB 3.0 port. But the biggest issue I have with this drive is that it's slow. Transfer speeds up to 260 megabytes per second. That's the trade-off. It's going to take a while to capture all of your footage, and you may have issues playing back high-quality 4K footage from prosumer or pro cameras. If you're in a 1080 workflow using smartphones or 1080 footage from a Canon 6D Mark II, you're good to go with a drive like this. G Technology sells an 8 terabyte Thunderbolt 3 G-RAID for $599 with transfer speeds up to 500 megabytes per second. This doesn't include an SD or CF card reader or USB port, but would be a solid option if you're in a 1080 or a DSLR mirrorless 4K workflow. These drives are configurable up to 36 terabytes as well, so plenty of storage. So what does the immobile organized editor look at to solve their storage needs? Well, this is the category I fall into, and for me, I want it all. A ton of storage, fast read-write speeds, data security and reliability, and something I can tuck under my desk so it's quiet and out of the way. That's why I use Promise Technologies' Pegasus line of RAID drives. I have 2 Pegasus 2 R8 drives with 24 terabytes of total capacity each, 21 terabytes when configured to RAID 5, which they both are. These drives, even at Thunderbolt 2 connectivity to my 2013 Mac Pro, have had no problem handling 1080p to 4K footage from cameras ranging from a Canon EOS R to a C300 Mark III. So I would highly recommend looking at a high capacity RAID array to meet all of your editing needs. Whether it's a G-Speed Shuttle, a LaCie 6-Big or 12-Big, or a Promise Pegasus 3, R4, R6, or R8, these drives have it all. Want them to be even faster? Configure them with SSD drives instead of enterprise level 7200 RPM hard drives. Now for some of these drives that would be incredibly expensive, but they'd also be ridiculously fast. Speed for these kinds of drives, RAID arrays, vary based on several factors. RAID configuration, amount of drives, SSD versus HDD, Thunderbolt 3 versus USB-C 3.1, but you can look at read speeds in the range of 2600 megabytes per second and write speeds in the range of 1700 megabytes per second with Thunderbolt 3 at RAID 0, which means you can support workflows above 4K if needed. So let's take a look at that chart again. For the mobile disorganized editor, a Samsung T5 drive at 2 terabytes is affordable and offers plenty of room for media, especially at 1080 resolution. The best option, in my opinion, would be to get a used LaCie rugged USB-C or Thunderbolt drive and open it up to put in a 4 terabyte SSD. I think if you're disorganized, you're going to want as much capacity as possible, even if it comes at a premium. It's worth it for you to not have to stress as much about running out of space and keeping your data organized. For the mobile editor who's organized, I'd snag a Samsung X5 at 2 terabytes. You've got great capacity and it's ridiculously fast. I personally would probably splurge and get a 2 terabyte LaCie rugged SSD Pro with Thunderbolt 3. It's about $700, but based on all the tests I've seen of drives in this class, this is the one that hits the sweet spot overall. For the immobile disorganized editor, I think LaCie's One Big Dock is a great option, since it can be configured to hold a ton of data, and it comes with a USB 3.0 Type A port, a CF and SD card reader, so you're not searching for USB hubs and card readers, especially if you use an iMac and don't want to reach behind to connect devices. It's going to be slower than an SSD, but if speed is a bigger issue for you, then look at G Technology's G-RAID with Thunderbolt 3. And finally, if you're an immobile organized editor like me and you want capacity, speed, reliability, data security, look no further than a full-on RAID array. G-Speed Shuttle, LaCie 6-Big or 12-Big, or a Promise Pegasus 3, R4, R6, or R8. These are very expensive drives, but they are definitely worth the investment if your career is video production. There are a lot of great used options for older versions. I've purchased all 3 of my Pegasus drives on eBay and have never had a problem. I recently added a 24 terabyte Pegasus 2 R8 with Thunderbolt 2 for a jaw-droppingly low $800 on eBay. $800 for 24 terabytes at Thunderbolt 2. Even if I upgrade my Mac Pro to a newer Mac Pro, I'd still use these drives for all of my YouTube editing and 4K client work. They can meet my data and post-production needs for several more years, and they've been an amazing addition to my post-production workflow. Hit me up in the comments if you've been struggling to figure out which hard drives suit you best. There are a ton of options out there, and each and every one of you has a unique set of needs that, unfortunately, sometimes can't be solved with one single product. Oh, and one last thing. Please remember to back up your hard drives. Whichever drive you choose to use, make sure you have another drive of equal capacity so you can do daily backups so your data is never at risk of being gone forever. To learn more about backing up your data, you can check out the links to a few of my other videos in the description below, and I'll also link one up here. And remember, the best thing that you can do to support the channel is to click the like button. If you haven't done that already, I'd greatly appreciate it if you did. If you're not subscribed, and I've noticed that only about 20-ish% of you watching are subscribed, click the subscribe button and the bell so you can get notifications every time we upload a video. Thanks everyone for watching, and until the next one, I'll see you all soon.
Conversation.